Just your first impression.
I'm sitting on a big, huge boulder.
Mm-hmm. I'm sitting on a huge boulder. Mm-hmm.
Didn't want to get off the cloud.
Mm-hmm. So where are you now? Look around.
I'm in a wooded, foresty area. Mm-hmm. With water.
Mm-hmm.
Sitting up high on a boulder.
You're sitting up high on the boulder, and what do you see as you're looking up out of that boulder? What's out there?
Water rushing by.
Water.
A big river.
Mm-hmm. Big river. How does the temperature feel in this place?
Warm.
Warm. Very good.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Nice breeze.
Very good.
Perfect.
Are you sitting down or standing?
Sitting
up?
Down.
Mm-hmm.
My knees bent.
So as you're looking at your body, take a look at it and focus on it and tell me, what do you look like?
I feel young, maybe in 20s, and kind of thin and fit, and not skinny, but fit.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I'm male or female.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at your feet. Are you wearing anything on your feet? Mm-hmm. You're barefoot?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
Barefoot or something little.
Okay. So just take your time, and as you are observing, you'll be able to know it into being. You may not be able to visualize it, but you'll know.
Something soft and mm-hmm. strappy.
Something soft and strappy. Very good. What else do you imagine there to be?
It's so pretty.
Mm-hmm. What do you see?
I just... the sounds of the water and the birds. And
mm-hmm.
The weather, the temperature's perfect, and I'm happy here.
Very good. Let's find out what it is that you're doing there. Is this a special spot for you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Sit. With my knees bent and my arms wrapped around my knees and
mm-hmm.
just enjoying the nature and enjoying just being there.
Mm-hmm. Very good. What else do you feel in this place?
I feel like I have to kind of steal away to get these times alone.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you have responsibilities?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what it is that you do. I'd like for you to close that scene like a book, and when you open it again, you'll be seeing yourself doing what it is that you need to do. Tell me where you are.
I think I'm walking on a dirt path
mm-hmm.
back to where I need to go.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where.
All right, so just tell me what you see along the way. Take me with you as you look around you and tell me what you see.
And some little wildlife and squirrels or chipmunks or some deer and some forest animals.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel when you see them?
I feel happy. I don't want to walk back.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to enjoy the walk.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what it is that you have to walk back to. See yourself arriving there now.
It's a lot of people and commotion and just people doing their daily things and
mm-hmm.
kids playing, and there's not much privacy there. That's why I enjoy going
mm-hmm.
to my special place.
As you look at these people doing their thing, how are they dressed? Focus
it's
on their...
It's warm, so they don't have too many clothes.
Mm-hmm. What kind of clothing are they wearing?
Natural clothes.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean by natural?
Some kind of... maybe burlap or cloth or
mm-hmm.
brown, a lot of browns and natural colors and
mm-hmm. Do they look like fabric or skins?
health, I think.
Mm-hmm. And what color are there, is the skin of these people?
Dark.
Dark. Mm-hmm.
They're in the sun a lot, with not very many clothes on.
Mm-hmm. And what's the hair like? Is it straight or curly? What does it look like?
Kind of messy.
Messy, okay.
Dark and messy, mm-hmm. Long. Kind of, they don't care.
They don't care. Very
no,
good.
It's just wild hair.
So let's look around this place. Is it a village?
It's like camping. It's like just out in nature.
Mm-hmm. Are there any?
It's a big field. I mean, not a field, but a big dirt area.
Mm-hmm.
And the trees are surrounding it. So it's a place where people gather and play and carry stuff and just do their daily activities.
Mm-hmm. Do you see any dwellings there?
I think they're back in the trees, I think.
Okay.
Away from the center. Seems like this is a center place. There's a big, big, some kind of something made out of logs where people meet. If it's raining or the weather's bad, then they go there to gather and eat or celebrate.
And what is it that you do that you don't
I'm
want
a
to
female.
Be? Mm-hmm. So what is it that
a
you...
A lot of things that women have to do. That's mm-hmm. why I liked getting away. Because
mm-hmm.
the women are expected to do certain things, and I don't like the role of having to do certain things.
Mm-hmm.
I think cooking, I think.
You don't like to cook?
I do, but I don't want to have to do it all the time, every day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And how old do you feel there?
In my 20s.
Mm-hmm.
26.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's find out now where it is that you spend most of your time. I'd like for you to close that scene and see yourself doing what you do most of the time.
Yes, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing kitchen cooking, cleaning stuff in this big... They made a big longhouse, like, with logs, but it's mostly open. It has roof and some sides, just posts coming down.
Mm-hmm.
So it's mostly open but protected, and there's tables that they made from wood, and there's a lot of pots and cleaning animals and cooking and on a fire in there, and every day there's so many people it has to be done.
Mm-hmm. And you don't like doing it?
I like doing it okay. It's just too routine. I want to do different things.
All right. Very good. What do they call you there?
Chiqua.
Chiqua. Very good. So Chiqua, let's find out what happens in your life. I want you to close that scene, and let's go to another significant scene in your lifetime. Where are you?
I'm back at the river.
You're back at the river.
I'm fishing.
Uh-huh. What do you fish with?
I don't know, a stick and twine or something. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think I care if I catch them. I just said the heck with it. I'm going to go do this instead.
Mm-hmm.
It's enjoyable, and I think I use fishing as an excuse to go there.
Mm-hmm. But you never catch anything?
Probably not, I don't think.
Mm-hmm. This is just a way for you to get away, Chiqua?
Yeah, it seems like I'm doing something for the group, but
it's really for you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's see if anything significant happens in this scene. Around and see if anything happens.
Seems like there's some kind of danger there that's... I need to be cautious and look.
Something's happening there? What are you feeling?
Well, there's just maybe a dangerous animal or something that I have to pay more attention to.
Follow your instinct and tell me what you feel is there.
A big cat.
Mm-hmm.
Like a big cat.
Mm-hmm. Do you see this big cat?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's happening?
It's just... I'm up higher on the boulders, and it's down lower and just kind of... It's not coming after me, it's just kind of aware of me, and I need to pay attention and be more aware of what's around me.
Mm-hmm.
It's not going to hurt me, I don't think.
Connect with this cat mind to mind, and let's find out what it's thinking. What's the first thing that comes into your mind?
It wants to show me it's the boss.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
I can let him think that.
Mm-hmm.
He is probably... We can share the area, though.
Mm-hmm.
I should probably just go back. Yeah, I think he's warning me just to... Maybe I'm there too much.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
It's okay.
Knowing that this is your favorite spot.
It's okay. Maybe I'm there too much anyway.
Mm-hmm. Does anything happen next?
I feel really nervous and shaky.
All right, let's see what happens. Take me through.
I don't know, I just feel like I should walk back and I feel real nervous.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like this feeling.
Mm-hmm. What are you picking up?
Something's following me.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel?
It's a cat.
Mm-hmm.
It's dark now. I'm just real nervous and sweaty and scared. I think I'm okay now.
Mm-hmm.
I think I made it back, but it's scary.
So how has this affected you now?
I don't know.
All right. Let's find out. Let's close that scene. Now let's go to another significant scene when something important is happening. Where are you?
Just in the village.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Just watching the kids play and happy with a group of people, and I don't go scouting around as much anymore. I'm older now.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about when you feel about scouting around? Is it out of your system now? Or are you scared?
Yeah, I think I go with other people and kids and make it more of a group thing now, or a small group thing.
Mm-hmm. Better be safe in groups.
Small group, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's significant about this event that you're looking at now? What happens?
I'm walking with children and I'm starting to get that feeling again.
Mm-hmm. How many children are with you? Tell me what's happening. What happened?
There's 4 or 5 kids.
Mm-hmm.
I scream at them to run back to the village, and the cat is getting me.
Mm-hmm. So you can see it as an observer now. Watch yourself as an observer and see what's happening. Tell me what's going on. What's happening?
I'm just done.
And tell me what's happened.
Well, I died. I'm on the ground in the dirt.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
Well, I got all bloody and ripped up and
mm-hmm.
I'm just don't care and I'm just above myself. And
mm-hmm. Tell me where you were ripped up. Look at your body carefully and see what areas you were ripped up. Please.
My side.
Mm-hmm. Where?
My thigh and hip and ribs.
Mm-hmm. Did the cat eat you?
I don't know. It's the cat's still there. Mm-hmm. I don't care.
Mm-hmm. I'd like for you to connect with that cat. It's very important. Connect with that cat and let's have a conversation with him. And let's find out why he killed you. What does he say?
I don't know.
Connect with him mind to mind. Let's find out why he chose you to kill you. What's the first thing that comes into your mind when you ask him?
That I treated the area like my own and I didn't think he could have certain areas to himself that everyone could enjoy that area.
Did he feel that you disrespected him?
I think he got tired of me just freely going. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
He likes to have boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And once in a while is okay, but I guess I was there too much.
Can you forgive yourself for not knowing any better?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you to look at the pieces of your body, and I'd like for you now as a spirit to put those pieces together. You cannot be whole if you're in pieces.
I don't think I'm in pieces. I think it's just big gouges.
Mm-hmm. So go ahead and heal those gouges. Send some light into those gouges. And I want you to mentally seal them up. Leave yourself completely intact as a body. Feel yourself becoming whole again, sending light to all of those areas, your thighs, your sides, your hips, and your ribs. Use your mind to piece everything together again, and tell me when you're done. does that feel now that you're in one piece?
Better.
Very good. So allow yourself to drift away from that scene, leaving
that
one.
I have to go to the bathroom.
All right. So in a moment, I'm going to touch your shoulder, and that will be your indication to open your eyes. You will remain in this beautiful state of relaxation, and when you come back, you will be back at the same exact scene. Eyes open. You're doing great. Thank you. Be there now. See yourself transitioning away from that body. And tell me everything that you experience along the way.
Feel light and floaty and relieved. Content and happy to go.
And tell me what you see or experience along the way.
Just feel light and floating and
let me know if anybody greets you there.
Don't really see anything yet.
Tell me what you feel.
I just feel like I'm enjoying the ride.
So tell me what the ride feels like. What does it feel like?
It just felt really good to take my time and rise through the clouds. Just peacefully rise up above the earth.
What does it feel like when you look down at the earth from where you are?
It's beautiful.
What feelings do you get as you observe it?
I'm just peaceful. It's just beautiful. It's getting smaller now. I love it.
What happens next?
It's bright light.
Does it have any particular color?
Gold. It just feels like the area is all bright and gold. There's not a distinctive light.
How do you feel in this place?
Feel good.
Do you have like any type of body in this place?
I don't think so. I think I'm just put everything in slow motion to enjoy the ride back.
Savor it back. Savor as you go back.
Yes. Feels warm and loving.
Now as you're drifting through that life, I want you to tell me if you look back at that last life that you left. Every life has a lesson and a journey and a mission. What was the reason that you were in that life? What were you there to do?
To decide whether something about boundaries.
You didn't respect the cat's boundaries, did you?
No.
What else about boundaries?
Sometimes boundaries are put where it inflicts on other people's mm-hmm. enjoyment of life, too.
Mm-hmm.
They both need to be respected.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that your boundaries were being disrespected, too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So it's almost like what you were feeling is the same as what the cat was feeling.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So you and the cat were very similar.
Yes, but we couldn't or didn't communicate to mm-hmm. cooperate with each other.
Right. So what lesson did you learn from that life, looking back at it?
To cooperate with boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
Not just assume that people are free. I didn't think about boundaries until someone wanted it.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was an area anyone could enjoy.
Mm-hmm. Not knowing the rules.
Not knowing the rules mm-hmm. and who made the rules.
Right. And even though this cat was not human, it had its own rules.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's find out now what you choose to do. Do you meet with anyone after this life?
I think I'm supposed to go meet with a small group.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about meeting them?
I want to take my time because I don't want to go back quickly.
Mm-hmm.
If that's what we decide,
mm-hmm.
I want to enjoy it here.
So what is it that you're enjoying on this trip?
Just feels like home and mm-hmm. it's full of light and open and free.
Mm-hmm. Kind of like what you wanted when you were as Chiqua.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You may have been looking for home there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So let's skip ahead now to where you meet with these people, with this group, and tell me where you are.
Meeting on a table.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably about 5 or 6 light beings,
mm-hmm.
guides or yeah, guides, I think.
Mm-hmm. Do they just look like light, or do
they look like gold light?
Mm-hmm.
Like body on a gold light, mm-hmm. bodies.
Mm-hmm.
Long robe, flowy, see-through, long clothes.
Mm-hmm.
They know me mm-hmm. pretty well, and they're welcoming me back.
How does that feel?
They find humor and tease me about lives.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what they're telling you. What do they say?
Just teasing me, like, what'd you think of that one?
Mm-hmm. What do you tell them?
Well, I'm okay with it, but I just don't want them to start talking about sending me back.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to go back.
So let's see what you're discussing at that table. What happens next?
They're not talking. I think they're going to give me some time to stay. I think I have to keep coming back all the time.
What is the reason why you keep coming back? What's your purpose?
I don't know, but I've been doing it for a long time.
How many times have you done this?
Oh, too many. Too many to count.
And when you're not on that, on the earth, what is it that you do when you're home? What's your job there?
I think I'm resting between trips. But I like being with the children or the younger spirits.
Let's find out.
To play freely with them. Oh, that's nice.
So your job is just to play with the children as they come home?
Yeah. There's big meadows. It's beautiful.
What do you
and
like?
We run and play and roll around in the grass. Try to give them enjoyment. Some of them have had rough trips, and it's nice to see them so happy. And I think it takes my mind off things and it lets me relax between my trips.
What
else? So nice here.
What does it look like there?
It's just a golden light that permeates everything, but you can create whatever you want. Just create big grassy fields and beautiful trees and whatever you want.
So what is the landscape that you like to create the most?
I think that one with the children. And there's dogs and puppies and dogs and that they're playing with that we manifest. They're just laughing and so happy.
What do you appear as when you're in this place? What do you look like?
It's a light body, golden light body.
What do the children look like?
Light bodies, but different shades.
It's a beautiful place. Very good. So let's leave that scene, and now let's go to the time right before you choose to be in the lifetime during. Of Denise. Look at the time before you chose the lifetime of Denise. Tell me where you go.
I think I'm at the table again, and there's more people there.
How many are there now?
They're in the background. They're like in the wings.
Does it seem like an important meeting?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. How do you feel while you're there? You don't seem very happy.
No, not really.
Mm-hmm. Are you the only one coming?
No.
Who else is with you?
Well, we're planning who will be who's gonna be in family and
mm-hmm. So look around the table and see who you recognize.
Just the guides mm-hmm. are there, and there's people in the wings.
Mm-hmm. What is it telling you?
I think everybody's trying to figure out who's doing what.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any say in it?
Yeah, but I feel like I'm leaving it up
mm-hmm.
to what they want to do. That I've done this a lot, so I'm letting them figure out what they want to do.
Mm-hmm. Do you trust these guides to do the best for you?
I trust the guides, and I trust the ones coming in with me
mm-hmm.
to do what's right and fair for everybody, to what, not right or fair, but what would be best for all.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what the theme is of this lifetime that the soul is going into as the woman of called Denise. What is this theme all about?
I think that her family is going to be what we're planning.
Mm-hmm.
Her children and family. She's just gonna go live her life, nice life, and then mm-hmm. until it's time for her family
mm-hmm.
and then everyone comes together
mm-hmm. So how many lives has Denise had on the earth already?
A lot. I don't know how. I think just too many to figure out.
Mm-hmm.
From the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Would she be considered an old soul?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What else can you tell me about this life that she's coming into? What is it that you, as the guides, are doing for her and her higher self?
She's it sounds weird.
Mm-hmm.
She's got this. She's on autopilot.
Mm-hmm.
She's got it.
She's done it so many times.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is that why she's had such a good life this time?
Yes.
Picking out good parents and children and everything. No drama.
No drama. I'm here so others can come in.
Mm-hmm. And who are these others that need to come in?
My children.
Mm-hmm. Are these children of hers new souls, or have they been with her before?
They've been with me before.
Mm-hmm. So what is the purpose of their lifetime together now?
Just family.
Just doing family?
We figure it out as we go.
Mm-hmm. Now, she has a bunch of questions, and I know that you could have shown her many past lives, but perhaps we can do that in between. She was asking about the type of job that she does when she's not in a body on Earth. Where does she go besides this beautiful place that she goes
That's
with?
That's where she goes.
That's it, always? Is that a different dimension or a planet?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
No, not planet.
It's just a dimension.
Dimension.
Mm-hmm. Does it have a number?
No.
No? Mm-hmm. Is this the same?
It can change.
It could change anytime.
The dimension can change when you're there.
Okay. So it adjusts.
You can go up and down and make, you can, it's adjustable.
Okay. Is this the same place where she goes during dream time?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Does she have any jobs when she dreams?
She likes being with the children.
Same thing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So it's really the same job all the time.
Yes.
Whether she's between incarnations or whether she's just asleep on her bed.
Yeah, and she likes to fly around.
What is that? Why does she crave it so much?
Because I don't know.
She says she feels like she misses it. She's flying over the Earth and other planets.
When you leave a body and you're getting lighter and lighter, and to watch the Earth, how beautiful it is, and as it gets smaller, and the stars.
Mm-hmm.
And then it transforms to darker, and then the light.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful feeling.
Is this light that we see on in the space, or is it on a different dimension? How does that work? Because it almost seems like she's going to a different planet or through a portal. How does that work?
You just keep getting lighter and lighter, and it just...
You leave the Earth?
It's there.
Okay,
it's
good.
Not a planet.
No, it's just a place. Mm-hmm. Does she have any ET connections? Since she's
Palladians.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell her what she did there?
She had one life.
Mm-hmm.
As
can you show her that life?
Island.
Mm-hmm. There's an island? Show her the life so she can see it.
It's an island.
Mm-hmm.
It's just... From a distance, it's... very tall mountains. Mm-hmm. Hawaii, like.
Is she a male or female there? Or does she have a gender?
I don't think she has a gender.
Okay.
I think she's looking at the island from above. From where, like cloud height, looking at it.
Mm-hmm.
That's where she lived once, as a Palladian.
Does she feel nostalgic about it?
It was a long, long, long time. Long time ago.
Now, she, in the same sentence she wrote about Lemuria.
Yes.
Was she? Did she have a lifetime about
there?
Mm-hmm. Is this where we're talking about?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So was she a Pleiadian on Lemuria?
Yes.
Okay. What was her purpose of being there at that time?
Of working with energies and healings with energies and crystals.
Is that some of the gifts that she has now that she's not using?
She misses that.
So can you tell her how she can bring those gifts back?
Their third eye.
What needs to happen there? What do we need
to
do?
There's a block.
Can you find out what's blocking that third eye? Take a look and see. Has it been blocked on purpose?
Seems like it.
But you go in there and see what's there.
Implant.
Who implanted that?
Troublemakers.
Can we get that implant out? Or did she sign a contract with them?
No.
All right. So can you please go in there and remove the implant, or do we need assistance?
Assistance.
All right. Can I call my archangel team? Can they help?
Yes.
All right. So I'd like to call on Archangel Michael and have him bring the team that he needs to bring in to go into her third eye and remove that implant. And tell me what's going on.
It's gone.
Very good. Very good. So I'd like Archangel Raphael to please flood that area with your healing light so that we can get that third eye activated.
Yes.
Thank you. Let me speak with the higher self. Now that that implant has been removed, what does it look like now?
Pink.
Can you activate it for her?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. So what are these spiritual gifts that have been blocked?
She was going to be distracted by all of it.
Yes.
And this life, she was going to enjoy family and a more simple life and I don't know.
So now that she's raised her family, she has the ability now to work on her gifts?
Yes.
Would you like to tell her which one of these gifts she should start working on first?
She already works with the pendulum. Just
will she be able to do readings for people?
She could, but I don't think she needs any hardware. She can just
she just knows it. Very good. Did she have anything to do with Kryon in a previous life?
No. She's been close and connects with him and he with her, the energy with her. She calls for the energy of Kryon and the collective energy comes to her.
So that's basically the reason why he comes, because he asked for her. She asked for him.
Yes.
Okay, good. So that's the only reason, actually. Whoever you ask for will help you out.
with intent and passion.
Yes, and she's done that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Very good. Who are her guides and angels? Who works with her?
Whoever she will call.
Well, she says she doesn't feel much around her.
Why? They come when she calls.
They do. And who does she call?
Angels and angels and one guide.
Mm-hmm. Who is this one guide? She wants to know who it is.
Elon.
Elon. Who is Elon?
He's been with her many times.
Mm-hmm. Does Elon have a purpose this time for being with her?
He reassures her.
Mm. Did he reassure her before she came here today?
Yes.
Very good. Does he have a message for her today?
Just enjoy the ride.
Mm-hmm. Just like she does after her lifetimes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Good. Would you tell her about her connection with Native Americans? She feels as if she could slip into their skill making and things like that. She was able to...
That was that life.
That was that life, okay. As Chiqua.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me where that lifetime was? What continent was it in?
America.
America. And was there a year around that time?
1860s.
Mm-hmm. What part of the country was it in?
South.
South?
Warm, the south, southwest.
Southwest, okay. Very good. We're talking now with the higher self, but she wants to know how to have a stronger connection with you. What would you like to tell her about that?
It will be now.
Mm-hmm. Now that she understands what you sound like?
And the third eye.
And the third eye is open. Very good. What about her guides? Do they send her a tingling at all?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who actually does the tingling?
Angels.
Angels. What is the significance of the tingling?
When she's on track, it's true.
Mm-hmm. That's when it's finally working, whenever she's on point?
Yes.
She feels the tingling? Okay. Very good. I'd like for you to do a body scan on her. And let's find out what's going on in her body. What do you see? What area do we need to focus on right now? The scan of a body, and her body should be bright white and light. Tell me if there's any areas in her body that we need to look at today. Any shadows or any movement?
Stomach.
The stomach. Would you allow me to speak with the stomach and see what's going on there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to bring that energy up, 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 up. Good evening. Can you tell me what it is that you're doing there in her stomach? Are you male or female energy?
Female.
Female. Mm-hmm. Have you always been with her? Or is it recent?
Miscarriage.
A miscarriage. All right. So, how old are you?
Before her last.
Mm-hmm. So are you a baby that never came?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell your mommy what's going on? Why did you attach to her?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. What have you caused her for being attached to her? Does she feel any symptoms of you being there?
No.
No. So why is it that you have attached to your mommy and not gone to the light after she miscarried you?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to go to the light now?
Yes.
All right. But let's have your mommy talk to you first. Would you like that? Mm-hmm. I'm going to touch your forehead, and you can talk to your baby. Go ahead and talk to your baby. What would you like to say?
You could go to the light and play with the other children.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Are you willing to let her go?
Yes.
Knowing how much you wanted a little girl?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Let me talk to the baby. Little baby, do you have a name that you like to be addressed?
What? Susie.
Susie. Susie, did you connect with your mommy because you knew how much she wanted a girl?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But you see that she had a girl now. And it's best that for you to go to the light. So perhaps you can help her from the other side. Would you like to do that?
Yes.
All right. So go ahead and detach yourself from her body. And I'm going to ask the angels of the light to surround you, Susie. And I want you to go ahead and say goodbye to your mommy.
Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Go up through the crown of her head, and Archangel Michael will take you by the hand and carry you back to the light. And tell me what you see there, Susie, when you get there. Who do you see?
Children.
The children. Go ahead and play with those children, Susie. And when your mommy comes back, after this lifetime, she'll be able to play with you again out in that meadow. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you so much, Susie. May the light of the universe always accompany you. And now let me speak with the higher self. Can you tell me what that area looks like now? Is it better? All right. Would you please flood it with white light? And go ahead and remove any of the symptoms that she was feeling in that area. And if you do a scan on her body and see if there's any other shadows, any other areas in which she may be carrying someone that doesn't need to be.
She's good.
She's good. Very good. Very good. Let's continue with the questions. She says that her eyes, after her recent surgery, were causing light sensitivity. Why is that? She sees halos everywhere.
It's the way the eyes adjust after the surgery and will be better after she has more work done.
Okay. Would you begin working on her now so it's not as uncomfortable?
Yes.
All right. So go ahead and start working on her eyes, so that even though she's going to continue working on them and having them adjusted, you can begin on your own. She also tells me that she's had very painful conditions on her right side for many years. Migraines, TMJ, shingles, hip, knee. What's going on there?
That life.
Now, we've already connected her in that life again. Did that help her with this exercise?
Yes.
Okay.
She's good.
Very good. Can we disconnect that life from her now so that she doesn't have those memories of that cat?
Yes.
Thank you. And is she good as far as the migraines and everything?
Yes.
She's okay. Very good. Would you check her chakras, please? Are there any that need to be aligned?
Throat.
The throat. What's going on with the throat?
She tends to hold back sometimes of the things that she's learned and...
Are these spiritual things?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And why does she have to hold them back?
It's not widely accepted.
Mm-hmm. So, how can we align her chakra if she's holding back? What would you like to tell her about that?
Speak and spend time with more of like kind.
Mm-hmm. So don't worry about the ones that can't understand. Just focus on the ones that she can talk with.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right, good. Can you please align her chakra today? And let's have her leave here with that one intact.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Are there any other chakras that are out of whack?
No.
No, very good. Would you take a look at her aura and see how her aura is? Is that okay?
Right side.
The right side. What's going on there?
Holes.
Holes in it. Is that from the cat?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So she actually came into this lifetime with that?
Yes.
All right. Would you heal that for her? Mm-hmm. Very good. What color is her aura today?
Violet.
Violet. What is the significance of that color for her today?
It's part of who she is.
Mm-hmm. She's a violet being?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it a very advanced being?
It's close to her gold color she enjoys.
Very good. That's the closest she can get?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are there any messages for her today? She wanted information in particular about all of these cosmic energies coming in.
She knows.
She knows. You don't need to tell her again. We are at 111 right now. I was hoping you would give me a really good one.
I think she has to use the bathroom.
Ah, okay. Would you be able to give her more information after the bathroom?
Yes.
Very good. So I'm going to touch your shoulder and open your eyes. And you remain in a beautiful trance. Be there now. We were speaking with the higher self about the changes that are occurring and the shifts. She had questions about how things are changing, if you had any messages, perhaps for herself or for others, about what's occurring in the energies, the shifting, the newer.
It's an exciting time that a lot of people came to see.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me more about that?
The veil gets thinner and thinner.
Mm-hmm.
Energy's coming.
The energies are coming. What happens as the veil gets thinner?
People become more psychic and...
Mm-hmm.
Can understand things better.
Mm-hmm. Is that why people seem to be waking up more now?
Yes.
To these spiritual practices?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And I know that people have asked many times, what is being awake all about? Can you give a description of what being awake spiritually is?
Being aware of who you are outside your body.
Mm-hmm.
Who you really are, your authentic self is.
Mm-hmm. And can you tell Denise who she truly is?
A light being.
A light being. Mm-hmm. Are we all light beings?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why do we choose this time around to be on Earth? What's going on here?
It's the beginning of Golden Age.
Mm-hmm. What's going to happen during this Golden Age? What changes are happening?
Changes. Lots of changes.
Mm-hmm. Are they physical changes, emotional, spiritual?
Systematic.
Mm-hmm.
Organizations and old paradigms collapsing.
Mm-hmm.
The beginning of their collapse.
Mm-hmm.
A new way of existing.
Mm-hmm.
Without the old energy.
Now, a lot of people fear this change because change is always scary.
No.
What can you say to ease people's mind about what it would feel like to be in this change?
The change is for the benefit of all.
Mm-hmm.
The new times.
Mm-hmm.
Become more of who they are, who they truly are.
Mm-hmm.
Be open for it. Be excited for it. It's a wonderful time now to anticipate it coming.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know that as a higher self and as a light being, you see life a little bit different than someone who's in a body. And when we talk about collapses and things like that, it brings about a little bit of fear.
Mm-hmm.
Are we talking about things that will hurt people?
Oh, no. The collapse of organizations.
Mm-hmm.
Old ways of doing things.
Mm-hmm.
That have not worked out. Mm-hmm. For humanity.
Mm-hmm. But some people may say, well, the old system is what we're using, and it's feeding us. It's how we make our food, and how we make our clothing, and how we make our money. No, how will the new system change everything?
The corrupt old systems are collapsing.
I see. So we'll be able to continue living our life.
Yes.
But without
changing to a more benevolent system and way of doing things. Mm-hmm. That benefits all. There's been a lot of corruption that is going. It cannot sustain itself in this new energy.
Mm-hmm. How will people know when this is happening?
It's already starting to happen.
Mm-hmm.
You'll slowly see as people wake up and things start changing for the better.
Mm-hmm.
But what isn't working has to break apart.
Mm-hmm. Now, people have talked about a new Earth. Is this Earth physical, or is it just a concept? What is this new Earth about?
Hmm.
New Earth is inside.
Mm-hmm. Inside of you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So as we make changes to ourselves, the Earth changes?
Yes.
You had talked about how this woman, Denise, when she goes between lifetimes, goes to a place to play with children and manifests whatever she wants.
Mm-hmm.
Are we able to do that on this Earth? In a way?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what's the best way that we can manifest a better Earth to help Gaia?
It has to be positive intentions.
Mm-hmm.
No fear.
No fear. Can it be done with one, or does it need to be done by many?
With one person?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. So one person could be the domino effect, can start the domino effect to change the Earth? Or do they just change it for themselves?
One person can manifest for themselves, mm-hmm. and mass consciousness changes things for the mass.
Okay. So as the veil is thinning, is it changing the consciousness of the planet?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are these changes coming from within the Earth? Are they coming from without? Because I've seen in many sessions where other life beings from other planets and other galaxies are helping. Is this something that it's our own thoughts, or are we receiving thoughts to manifest from others? How does that work?
I'm not sure what you mean.
It's like the chicken or the egg theory. I mean, are we creating our own Earth, or are there others that are helping us create a new Earth?
Both.
Both.
Mass consciousness brings on the new Earth,
mm-hmm.
and to access it, we do that from within.
Mm-hmm.
To individually access it.
Yes.
But it is a physical place that has been manifested for those that go inside to take themselves there.
Mm-hmm. How do you get to this place? What's the best way of doing it?
Through intention.
Mm-hmm. How can Denise best do it? She told me she used to meditate more, and now she's not. Is it necessary to meditate? Does it help?
It's fine. It's not necessary, but it's beneficial.
Mm-hmm. To set the intention better, or to change the vibration?
Raises vibration.
Mm-hmm. Is there a message about DNA changes?
Crystalline will be becoming crystalline.
Crystalline. Is this in connection with what Cryon has been talking about?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So the DNA is automatically changing in everyone?
DNA is slowly being changed on the planet,
mm-hmm.
from energies coming in and interacting with Gaia.
Mm-hmm.
And new beings coming in are better adapted to it.
Mm-hmm. They already have the changes made?
Some, yes.
Mm-hmm. How do we recognize that our DNA has been changed? How would we know? Or do we?
Just slowly evolves.
Mm-hmm.
You would not know.
No. It just happens. Is there any particular way that our DNA is being changed?
It's a slow process that is gradually happening over a period of time.
Mm-hmm.
Through new people coming in.
Mm-hmm.
The young ones.
Mm-hmm. They're changing it themselves.
They're coming in pre-wired.
Okay.
Where others are slowly changing.
Mm-hmm. So these new kids are
easier.
They're plug and play already. They already have all of the components.
More so than the rest.
Mm-hmm. So we just have to continuously be upgraded, I guess, or changed.
Hmm. Electromagnetics, mm-hmm. The sun and earth.
Mm-hmm.
And cosmic energies are all working together.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that is being used now on earth that is keeping us from being changed? Anything that's stopping us, for example, Wi-Fi or things like that. Anything that's hampering the process.
Yes, there's things that hamper, but we'll not be able to sustain the higher energies coming in at this time.
Okay, so it's too strong. It's not gonna, we don't have to worry.
It won't work anymore soon. It's old energy, old interferences that will not be able to sustain themselves.
Mm. In what way? Is this what you're talking about, the collapse of things?
There's been malevolent interferences with weather and foods and and with the higher energies coming in, it will dissipate that. It'll overpower that.
Okay. When will we finally see a time when we don't have to worry about the food that we eat?
It's coming.
It's coming.
It takes time, but more and more people become aware to it and quit accepting it.
Quit accepting the lower standards or
yes.
the poison food?
Yeah.
For example, the organic movement?
Yes.
Mm-hmm, demanding better food?
Spend your money on what you want.
Mm-hmm.
Put your energy where you want it to go.
Mm-hmm.
And quit putting the financial energy into what is not best.
Mm-hmm. Is that food that's being modified hurting our DNA?
to an extent.
Is there anything that's hurting people, for example, losing their hair or affecting their thyroid or giving them illnesses like diabetes and cancer? Is there anything that's affecting them like that?
There's environmental and thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
A combination of a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm. Let's take hair loss, for example. What would cause someone to lose their hair? Let's use Denise as an example.
Thinking about it and worrying about it,
mm-hmm.
puts more energy into it.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of put manifesting it due to worrying about it so much.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else that you would like to tell Denise or anybody else today?
You're doing a wonderful job. Both of you.
Thank you very much. And then when Denise opens her eyes from this session, she's probably going to think she made it all up. What would you like to tell her in advance about what she's going to be saying to herself?
Trust.
Mm-hmm. Trust in it.
Trust in it.
Very good. Do you have a message for anybody else today? Perhaps her children? No, are we complete today?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
So we just had a very interesting session here in San Francisco area. And how do you feel about it?
It's just absolutely amazing. You don't think it'll work. and it works.
And it works. So. Yeah. Your first question to me, or your first concern was, what if I don't get hypnotized, right?
Yeah, and when you did that thing you do, I don't know if you want to give it away.
No?
Oh, my God.
You felt hypnotized.
Don't you think it did work for
well,
you?
Well, it worked for you, right? So you felt you were really, it worked for you.
Yeah, yeah.
So how does it feel being hypnotized?
Very different. You can't help but just say what comes, and you want to try and fight it and say, well, I don't know. And then you have to just relax and say, just say it. Just say it.
Uh-huh. And the more
so that's what I was doing, but I know when I look back at it.
So we were talking about the new Earth and the DNA changes and all that, and I thought that was pretty interesting. How is that coming in for you? How were you feeling it coming in?
I felt like there were some things that I didn't want to say.
Mm-hmm. Was,
well, you know.
You feel like they were holding back?
Yeah.
Really?
Like, do you want to cut? Not that there was anything fearful or anything, but mm-hmm. they didn't. It didn't want to
talk too much.
I don't know, I'm still spacing.
At least it worked.
Yeah, it works.
Well, your main concern was it's not going to happen.
Yeah, it works.
Mm-hmm. And how's your body feel?
I kind of out of my body, that's how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I can walk down to my car.
Well, we're gonna wait to ground you a little bit. You're not gonna go right away, but yeah, you were out there, and you felt that fear, and you felt everything. That was amazing.
I almost felt like I was just gonna jump out of the couch, and I think that's why I said,
"You need to use
the restroom."
Yeah,
because I felt like if I didn't, I was gonna explode.
Yeah. And sometimes
it grounded me.
Yeah.
I had to ground myself.
Yeah. Come back to
a... Yeah, I had to calm it down a little bit.
Uh-huh. And then when you went back in, back to the same place, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you didn't have to worry about the intermission. It came back. The movie came back.
Yeah, yeah.
Good. So do you recommend this to our
Absolutely.
Friends out there?
Absolutely. Everyone. Everyone should experience this.
It's just
the best.
Thank you. And
I waited a long time.
How long ago did you do this?
I think I've been waiting. I think I've been watching since, well, I've seen all your videos, but I think I've been watching since the very, maybe around the 20th one or so.
Wow.
So a long time.
A long time.
Or the 10th or so.
And how does it feel
and
now?
Immediately when I was seeing them, I was thinking, I'm going to have this done. I'm going to have this done. And I was going to plan a trip to Miami. And then you started announcing that you're going out in the world.
Yes. I'm in San Francisco right now. And, so what is the difference between watching the videos and being in it? How do you feel? Because most people think it's
more
be...
relaxing watching it at home, watching someone else.
Well, you can sit in your PJs and you know, eat popcorn.
It's a little, it makes you a little nervous because you don't know what you're going to experience.
Right.
You know?
Right.
It's much different.
Well, it's different for me, too. I mean, I have no idea what's going to happen next. And this has changed me a lot because I was a real change weenie. I don't like change.
Oh.
And every session,
change.
And every session makes me go through a brand new experience. So
mm-hmm.
I've gotten used to a lot of changes now.
You have a fun job.
Yeah, because I get to travel through time and space. Mm-hmm. Who knows where I'm going to be? I could be meeting a dinosaur one day and fish, or a boy. Exactly. I could be doing anything. So this has changed me, too, in that way that, you know, I'm learning to adjust to different people and different vibrations. And you realize that, you know, life is not what you thought it was.
No.
Mm-hmm.
So much
good.
More.
Good. So if you want a session with me, you know where to go, albaweinman.com. I do travel, so if you want to sign up for my newsletter, you'll see where I'm going to next, and hopefully it'll be to a city near you. All right, so until the next time, bye. This is my best bite. This is the favorite part. It's so good. Oh, boy.